sub review for you. So first of all, let's take a look at Godzilla in his box. Alright, so in the box wise, we see in the front we have Godzilla and the individual robots, and over here we have them in their weapons and the pose. And on the other side we have Godzilla with his shield and the other three robots in standing pose. And over here we have Godzilla with his sword, and here in the combination mode and at the back we'll probably see more details, like we have Kuraio with all his weapons, and we have next up we have Kameo with his weapon as well, and we have Bikushino with his weapons as well. And this combination, and these are the weapons that they have. So when you open up this box, alright, you're gonna get the first off this. Wow, this is a very very cool representation. Let me just try to pull this higher. Whoa, cool. Alright, so this is it's a very big box, and the presentation for this is very much like it's a vintage version. So we have all the robots lined up with weapons. So very, very cool, and very kudos to Bandai. Okay, let me just shift the camera up a little bit. Very kudos to Bandai for bringing us this vintage box presentation. I'm sure a lot of us who used to have this toy as a kid will definitely bring back memories. This is really, really cool. Okay, apart from this, I'm just moving on to the accessories. We have this whole set of weapon packs with the wings, with the weapons, with the stands, with the weapons over here. So these are accessories which I will set up in a moment in my next video. And finally we have the spare set of arms and hands, interchangeable for every robot, and of course not forgetting the instruction booklet. So alright, so this is the end of part 1 of my presentation of the video. Do stay tuned to part 2 of my video, whereby I'll review the individual robots as well as their weapons and accessories.